Welcome to Fire Deliverance Ministries with God's servant Tammy Carter, where we expose the devil. The Lord showed me the church is asleep. They're in praise and they are in worship, but they are asleep. Even through the preaching of the word, they're still asleep. And Jesus sent his servant into the harvest to awaken the church. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Good Sunday morning to you, Polk County. This is God's servant, Tammy Carter, with Fire Deliverance Ministries, located in Vero Beach, Florida. It's a blessing, hallelujah, as always, a privilege and an honor to be in the presence of a mighty people, a royal people, God's people. Glory be to God. Well, people of God, I thank you for tuning in to the broadcast on this Sunday morning. And can somebody magnify the Lord with me on this morning? Can somebody give God some praise? Just raise your hand, no matter where you are, and just say, hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you for another day's journey. Thank you for how you kept me, Father. Thank you for how you carried me, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Know this morning that you got something to give God thanks for. He's a good Father. He's a loving Father. He's a merciful Father. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. He's a gracious Father. Come on, somebody. Praise God on this morning. Magnify him on this Sunday morning. Raise your hallelujah. Come on, somebody, in the presence of your enemies. Hallelujah. You've been going through all week long. The enemy's been on your left and on your right. Hallelujah. But know today that you're still here. It was because your Father who kept you and brought you through. That's something to praise God for. Glory be to God. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. See, sometimes people want to stay pretty. Sometimes people don't want their face to look certain kind of ways. But you got to know sometimes, hallelujah, when you're in this battle of life, that hallelujah, you're going to get ugly sometimes in your praise and in your worship. And tears are going to flow. Hallelujah, your hair going to get messed up. But you're going to press, hallelujah, press into God. Oh, my Father, hallelujah, because you need him. We can't make it in this world without him. We need him every day, every minute, every second. That's all the enemy wants, is just what, 1 minute with you, and so he can take you out. But every second, hallelujah, and every minute, when God keeps us and covers us, he's keeping us from the adversary. Come on, somebody. I'm going to go into prayer at this time. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God, I pray today that you would forgive me, Father. Forgive me of every sin, oh God. Hallelujah. Glory in the name of Jesus. And I bring up your people on today. Hallelujah. I pray that you would forgive them of their sins. I pray that you would have mercy on their souls, oh God. I pray that you would purify them and sanctify them, God, because you are a holy God. And can't nothing come into your presence that's not clean, that's not holy, that's not sanctified. Hallelujah, Lord God. And I pray today that the people will be sanctified and remain sanctified for thy coming, oh God. Hallelujah. Then they will be without spot, wrinkle, nor blemish, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray today, God, for an awakening. amongst your people, God, a spiritual awakening, God, that will lead to revival. But first they got to be awoke, God, because even in a revival, people still can be asleep. So I'm praying for a spiritual awakening, God, amongst your children, amongst your people, oh God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that the sleep will, oh my God, that they will wake up and they will begin to run this race, and that they will begin to see the world for the truth that it is in the unseen. Oh my God. Hallelujah, Lord God. And I thank you for doing it on today. I pray that this word will go forth and it will release, oh my God, the bound and the ones that are in captivity. I pray that it will heal the sick. I pray that it will raise the dead. I pray that it will loose the addictive bondage today, God, in the name of Jesus. And I plead the blood. I plead the blood throughout this nation today. I plead the blood in the White House. I plead the blood in this country. I plead the blood in the churches, God. I plead the blood. Hallelujah. Because it's the blood of Jesus that saves. Oh my God. Oh, glory. And Lord God, I just lift up your name on today and I magnify your name. Hallelujah. Because all praise and all glory and all honor belongs unto you. Hallelujah. And I thank you on today, God, for hearing your servant. Thank you, God, and amen. Hallelujah. Well, people of God, know today that's what the word is going to be on about. Making sure that your garment is clean. Hallelujah. That you're ready to meet the Messiah. Hallelujah. People are understanding, know that this is a battle. And the enemy is doing everything he can to defile your garment, to stain your garment. Hallelujah. I was just thinking on yesterday that people just don't know the depths of the devil. I was reading, I think it was Revelation about the depths of Satan. And I was just thinking on yesterday that without God, without Jesus, like he said, if you don't eat of his body and drink of his blood, that you won't make it. And it's so true, because everything that I know and been trained to know by heaven, you won't know. You can't beat him without Jesus. It takes Jesus to keep you in this battle and to give you the victory. So you cannot be hot and cold at the same time, which will make you lukewarm. You got to be hot and stay hot. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I'm going to read a scripture on today, coming out of the book of Ephesians. And the Bible reads in Ephesians 4, verse 27. Let me start at verse 26. Be ye angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. So the Bible is saying, be ye angry, but sin not. And then he says to not let the sun go down on your wrath. Because see, then he comes back and say, neither give place to the devil. Because guess what? If you go down, go to bed angry and you're mad and you're continually staying mad, now you're giving place for the devil to come on your territory. See, you got to understand that's what the enemy wants to do. And when he makes place on your territory, he has taken you into captivity and you are bound by the wicked one. Glory be to God. See, a lot of people don't understand what it means to give place to the devil. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. The devil can also, hallelujah, send people in your life that are his agents. so that he can make place on your territory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You don't even know that people that are in your life, been there for years, have been sent by the devil. Hallelujah. Some of you can have calls on your life, and the enemy knows it. So what can we do to set her up or set him up so that they cannot walk in that call? We'll send somebody on their territory. A smile in your face. Tell you how much they love you. But you don't even know it's an assignment by the enemy. And then one day when the call comes, hallelujah, you're up under severe attack and you don't understand why. Because the enemy is right there on the territory. My God. Trying to stop what God has ordained upon your life. My God. Ooh, help us, Holy Ghost. He's deceitful. The enemy is very deceptive. That's why the Bible warns he was a deceiver from the beginning. Glory be to God. And he's the deceiver of the world. Come on, somebody. So let me state, the Bible says he was a liar from the beginning. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And a deceiver. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So let me go to another scripture that I have for you today. And I was studying this on this morning. And I just began to cry because, you know, as Paul warned us to work out our salvation with fear and with trembling. And that's what we have to do. Now, when the Lord was beginning to reveal to John what would take place, hallelujah, among the church, and he was beginning to tell him about the state of the churches, and when he told him to write unto the church in Sardis, and he was telling him in Revelation 3 verse 4, he says, thou hast a few names, even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments. And they shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. See, when I read that scripture, it took me to the one word that stuck out the most was feel. Hallelujah. Understand, people of God. Hallelujah. You got to go deep in God and have a relationship with God to know that you're living holy. You're living righteous. I'm not telling you, hallelujah, that you can just receive what the pastor say. Oh, y'all holy, y'all making it. No, you better know. And the only way you're going to know is by the one who is going to let you into his kingdom. Pray and ask God to show you the state of your spiritual garment. Is it white? Is there anything that you need to locate in your life to clean up? Hallelujah. Because you don't want your living to be in vain. And as that word says, a few. He found a few names in Sardis. Hallelujah, my God. And that took me to the scripture on in the book of Matthew. When the Bible speaks in Matthew 7 and 14. When he says, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. People of God, we got to know today, are we living righteous? Is our garments clean? When I say the word righteous, is our ways and our doings pleasing to God, not unto man, not unto what your pastor say, but what God says? Pray and ask God to reveal it to you. Give you a spiritual awakening. Hallelujah. Well, people of God, my time is coming. My time is gone. This is God's servant, Tammy Carter, with Fire Deliverance Ministries. Be blessed, be encouraged, and be empowered on today. Amen.